Hello viewers, I'm Dr. Neha Gulati from University Business School, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Let me connect you back to the module, the previous module where we discussed about the Mendeley, its introduction and the applications of Mendeley for a researcher. In this present module, moving ahead, I will discuss how to launch Mendeley so that you can start having practical exposure to this wonderful tool. Launching Mendeley is a two-step process. First step is to download Mendeley Desktop. Second step is to create your account on Mendeley. As I told you in my previous video, when we were discussing the introduction of Mendeley, that Mendeley is both a desktop and a web program. Now, I must tell you that in order to use Mendeley Web, that is online Mendeley, it is not required to download Mendeley Desktop in your computer. This can be very well operated by only creating an account in Mendeley. If you have an existing account in Elsevier, no need to create another account. Elsevier's user account can be very well connected to Mendeley. But viewers, Mendeley Web being an online Mendeley version works only with internet connection. Hence, at time with low or poor internet connectivity, Mendeley provides a substitute to its user, which is known as Mendeley Desktop. Many features of Mendeley can be explored on Mendeley Desktop even without the internet connection. Only two functionalities, literature search and online support, is deactivated. Nothing to worry, viewers. Whenever you have internet connectivity, explore these two features. Well, the process to create your folders, handle your research, reference management, filtering, all these options available without internet connectivity. So you can explore them. Now, I will be discussing the steps that you have to follow to download Mendeley Desktop. I underline this by saying Mendeley Desktop. We do not need Mendeley Web downloading. Steps to download Mendeley Desktop. The first step is that you have to establish a connection with the Mendeley website. For this, in your browser, you type the web address www.mendeley.com. Mendeley web page is displayed for you. Now, as you see in this figure, there is a download button on the top right side. Click on the download button. Now, the second step, if you see this figure, there's plenty operating system options which are available in Mendeley. Like, Mendeley Desktop is available for Windows, Macintosh and Linux operating system. So the second point that you have to consider is about selecting the operating system for which Mendeley Desktop is to be downloaded. Suppose you want to download it for Windows. So click on Download Mendeley Desktop for Windows. On selecting the operating system, the download process begins. Now, another screen is displayed. In this screen, click on Run button. A dialog box is displayed, which further tells you the percentage of the content that has been downloaded. Finally, once the download is complete, you get another screen, which is a setup screen. Welcome to the Mendeley Desktop Setup Wizard. In this wizard, click on Next button. You are presented with the screen that displays a license agreement. Read the instructions and click on I agree in license agreement. Finally, on completion of download, Mendeley icon is displayed. It is visible on your computer screen. Now, you have to install Mendeley. That is, choose the location where the Mendeley executable files should be stored in your computer. Mention here destination folder, if desired, should not be changed. That is, Whatever are the destination folder's location, please do not change it. Now, click on Next button, which is shown in the figure, to finally install Manly Desktop in the destination folder which has been mentioned. But in case you want to change the destination folder, very carefully click on the Browse button and browse the location. Set up the location where you want the Manly executable files to be stored. Finally, you complete the setup process by clicking on the Install button, which is shown in the next figure. This dialog box explains that the Manly Desktop installation is in progress and extraction of the files is in progress. Now, once the installation is complete, a dialog box is displayed. Click on Run Manly Desktop and Finish button. The installation of Manly Desktop is complete. So, viewers, you're finally done with the installation of Manly software on your computer. I need to underline that since you have downloaded this Manly Desktop on a particular hard drive of your computer, in case you want to access Manly from some other computer, you can still access Manly using the Manly web version. But if you want to have an access to Manly Desktop, then you have to download Manly onto that computer with another hard drive also. So the installation process of Manly Desktop is complete now. Let us now discuss the steps which are required to create your own account in Manly. This is very important, because until you create an account in Manly, Manly won't provide you an access to the website. So let's now discuss the steps which are desired to create user account in Manly. As I told you that you get a Manly icon on your computer screen once the download is complete. So now the first step that you'll be following will be clicking on the Manly Desktop and logging in. So as that icon is clicked, you get a login screen which displays Welcome to Manly. It asks you to enter your email and password. But since you are using Manly for the first time, you are a new user to Manly. So for a new user, you have to click on Register button to create your own user account. If you see Register button is available at the lower left side of the screen. When you click on the Register button, it asks you to enter few details. So you enter any of your existing email ID, password and your details like your first name, last name, field of study and your affiliation. For an existing user, that is those who already have an account in Manly, click on Sign button, which is available on the right side of the screen. Enter your existing credentials. If you have an Elsevier account, you can even sign in by using that account. So what Manly needs to enter is your email and the password. Friends, on successful login or on successful creation of a Manly account, you have an access to online Manly, that is Manly web. You get this screen displayed where your name is on the top right side of the screen. Wherever you create a Manly account, you get 2 GB of space for managing your contents in Manly. Now in case when you do not want to use Manly web, then you can switch to Manly Desktop. For switching from this screen to Manly Desktop, you have to follow a procedure. First, you click again on the Manly icon. You get back the Manly Desktop screen, login screen. Re-enter your login credentials. After successful login, a Manly Desktop screen as shown in the figure is displayed. Now this is the screen for Manly Desktop. If you switch from Manly web to Manly Desktop or vice versa, then synchronization is important. This can be handled by using the sync button, which is available in the toolbar. It is also available in the file menu. Understanding the concept of the desktop screen, it shows that a reference manager and citation plugin for MS Word has been installed. Close this welcome box by clicking on the close button. Now, finally, you get Menlay desktop screen. The screen that you're getting here is a collection of different components. It is divided into four components as illustrated in this figure. At number one is the upper left pane. This provides you with the folders. Folders I have explained in my previous video. Please connect to my previous video to have a look and better understanding about the types of folders. At number two, the lower left pane is the filter option. This has also been discussed in the previous video. Let me just connect back. Filter allows you to search for any specific document on the basis of author name, keywords, my tags and publications. The center pane at number three is actually the library. This is actually the place where your contents are displayed. Now, if you see the screen, you are a new user to Menlay with no contents added in Menlay. So library is initially empty. Once documents are added in Menlay, they are listed or displayed in library in the center pane. Documents can be listed in the form of table or citations. You can go to view in order to change from one style to another. Every document has an entry which is created by Menlay. It is referred as a document entry. So, for every PDF or every web page that is stored in Menlay, an entry is created. This entry consists of authors, title, year, published in. Now, this published in refers to whether the PDF that you are referring to has been published in a journal, in a conference proceeding, book, report, etc. Added. It is the month and the year when the document is added in Menlay. Now, if you see the figure that explains you about the Menlay desktop screen, in the library, that is in the center pane, every entry has three symbols which are preceded by the author names. Now, what these symbols predict? The first symbol is a star. Usually, whenever you enter any document in Menlay, that is, whenever a document is added in your Menlay library, the star is usually white in color, or you can simply say it is grayed. The star is used to represent a favorite or not favorite document. To make a document favorite, click on the star. The color of the star changes immediately from white to yellow, and the document that you have selected will be transferred to a built-in folder called Favorites. If you re-click the star, then the star becomes white or grayed down. This document becomes unfavorite and is automatically removed from the folder Favorite. The second symbol that is being displayed is a circle. This is used to mark a document as read or unread. To mark a document as read, click once on the circle. It will shrink in size and turn to gray color. The document that you've marked as read, that is your selected document, is immediately transferred to a folder recently read. Viewers, recall. What is recently read? This is a built-in folder that has been discussed in a previous video. If the circle is clicked again for the same document, then the circle returns back to its original size and it turns green. Document becomes unread. This is automatically removed from the folder recently read. Now, I'll be discussing about the very important pane that is the right side at number 4. This is crucial, very important component. Why? Because it is actually the metadata of your document. The right side displays the details of the document. Suppose in your Mendeley library, there are 10 documents. You select a document by clicking on a document double. That is, you perform a double click. The document is opened for you, and on the right side, the details are displayed. Now, what are those details? These details include the type of the document. It is very important to understand the different types of documents. Mendeley supports 20 different types of documents, including journal. If a document has been published, if a manuscript has been published in a journal, so the type of the document or the type of the manuscript is journal. If the manuscript has been published in a conference proceeding, so its type is conference proceeding. If a document is published as an article in a book, then it is book article. Mendeley wonderfully also allows you to have web pages. So at that time, if you download a web page, the type will be web page. It also supports thesis, patent, reports, working paper, and many more. Viewers, you must be very excited to now start building your own library in Mendeley, to have a personalized library in Mendeley, to have an experience with hands-on Mendeley. So, the next topic I'm discussing is how to build a Mendeley library and what to do with this library now. Mendeley facilitates user in building up a personalized library by adding, organizing these documents for you in different folders. Three steps are required to build your Mendeley library. The first step is you must know what to add. As discussed, I told you Mendeley supports 20 different types of documents, which includes the following that has been displayed. Mendeley also supports an article from a magazine and a newspaper. Once you have put these things into your Mendeley library, you're ready to use Mendeley. Now, the question that would be striking your mind would be, from where do you get these documents and how you can add them into your Mendeley library? So viewers, you must be wondering from where to add these documents. Documents can be added to the Mendeley library by drag drop from the computer. That is, if you have any existing files in your computer, you can simply drag and drop them into the Mendeley library. Or you can import the documents from academic databases or search engines. The steps how to add these files by using both the mechanisms, manually from computer and directly from these academic databases, is explained. Let us now cover the first point, computer. That is, how can you manually add the PDFs available on your computer? For this, the first option discussed is drag and drop of the PDFs from your computer to Mendeley library. The second, click on Add Files or the File menu. This allows you to browse your computer and select the PDFs which are available. Using this way, you can add not only one file, a complete folder can also be added. Seeing this screen, the options of Add Files, Add Folders, this allows you to manually add the files or the complete folder. Once the files or the complete folder is uploaded in your Mendeley library, a long list of documents is displayed in the center pane, which refers to your Mendeley library. As seen in the screen, there are multiple documents which have been loaded. Initially, all these documents are transferred in the default folder called All Documents. Documents added in the library shows one document has been selected, Gulati, Neha, Gurd, Atul. This refers to the name of the authors. A secured cognitive agent-based multi-strategic intelligent search system is the title of the article. 2018 is a year of publishing, and this has been published in a journal of King Saud University. It has been added in the Menlay Library on 22nd August. Well, the details about this article are displayed on the right side. Suppose an article by Rajat Sandhir Halder, which is the second last article, is selected. By double clicking on the article, you can completely view the article, read the article as the article is open for your access. And on the right side is the metadata, that is the details of the documents. Let us now explore what is the meaning of each and every detail. As I discussed, Menlay supports 20 different types of articles. So, seeing into the screen, we understand this is an article which has been published in a journal, Biochemica et Biophysica Ecta, and the title of the article being Mitochondria as a Centrally Positioned Hub in the Innate Immune Response. The name of the authors being Rajat Sandhir, Abhishek Halder, Aditya Sunkaria. The page number being 1090 to 1097. An article has been published in the year 2017 with the volume 1863 and issue 5. When this document is stored in Menlay, Menlay automatically extracts these details and the metadata is ready for you. So, you have now your folders and the documents. The second point I will be covering is how you can automatically import the documents from the academic databases or from the search engines. Menlay Web allows you to import the papers, that is the manuscripts, web pages, directly from search engines and the academic databases into your own Menlay personalized library. There is no need to separately download these papers and then upload them into your Menlay account. Figure 18 represents the process to directly add PDFs from ScienceDirect to your own Menlay library. In this figure, a text box is displayed with the content e-governance. Suppose you are interested in looking for the content published on the topic e-governance. As you click on search, you get a long list of documents from ScienceDirect. Some of these manuscripts can be downloaded, while others are through payment. You select the PDFs that can be downloaded and available in free access by clicking on the dialog box. Once you click on the dialog box on the left side of the title, a right mark appears. This shows that these documents have been selected. That is, you can easily export more than one document at a time. Now, click on Export. Then, use the option Save to Menlay. On the right side of the screen, top right side, you get an access to your name, which shows that you are currently logged in into Menlay, and you can directly export these documents from ScienceDirect to your Menlay account. Now, if you are not logged in into Menlay, then it allows you to enter your login credentials. So first log in and then you can export these documents. Once these documents have been exported, these will be available in your Menlay account. Here comes the importance of synchronization. That is, you are using Menlay Web for transferring these documents. But on the other hand, you want to explore Menlay Desktop. So, in your Menlay Desktop screen, that is your home screen of Menlay, click on the Sync button to synchronize Menlay Web and Menlay Desktop. As a result, in few minutes, you'll be able to see list of all the documents that you've exported directly from Mendeley Web Importer into your Mendeley desktop. So, friends, I've explained you how you can directly transfer the files from these academic databases. Now, I'll be discussing about where to add these documents. Mendeley allows you to keep all your research at one place. Wondered how? It supports multiple types of folders. The folders include built-in folders and the user-defined folders. Built-in folders, as discussed in the previous module, are the system-generated folders, and Mendeley places them under the heading My Library. My Library helps you to organize the content in different folders and subfolders. It also allows the user to view the entire library content. Further, it also allows you to segregate documents into different subfolders like favorites, recently read, etc. As previously mentioned, there are 7 built-in folders. These built-in folders are further explained in detail. First, all documents. This folder contains all the documents which are available in your Mendeley library. Whenever you add a document, it automatically is transferred to this folder called All Documents. So, to see all the documents that are available in your Mendeley, click on the folder All Documents. You get a list of all the documents which are available in your Mendeley library. Second, recently added. These are those documents which have been added recently in your personalized library. Third, recently read. It includes those documents which are opened by you, that is, the documents which have been read by user are placed in this folder. Fourth, favorites. Obviously, your favorite documents are placed here. The documents which have been placed in this folder have a yellow colored star in the beginning of the document entry. Next, needs review. It consists of those documents for which the details or the metadata needs to be further checked. That is, Mendeley is not sure about the details and asks the user whether the user assures these details are correct or not. Next, My Publications. These include the type of the publication of that particular document. Unsorted. Documents that are not placed in any of the above folder are placed in unsorted folder. Viewers, this is all about built-in folders. This is not just enough. You must have an opportunity to create your own folder. Yes, Mendeley provides you this feature also. You can create a folder of your choice. Any name can be given to this folder. Now, I will be discussing about how can you create your own folder. So the steps to create a new folder are as follows. You see, there is a command create folder in the left pane at number 1, which I discussed while telling you about the components of Mendeley. There are 3 dots after this option. This means it further needs some input from the user. Now, what is that input? When you click on create folder, it asks you to enter the name of the folder that you want to create. Right click at any of the location in your My Library, you get the command of new folder. Click on new folder and type the name of the folder. Click on create a new folder in Mendeley toolbar beneath the menu bar. That is, you can create a folder by using all these options. Mendeley also allows you to create subfolders in all of these user-defined folders. Steps to create a subfolder is same. Only difference is that you have to select the folder within which further subfolders are to be created. That is, the folder in which you have to create subfolders should be your active folder. Represents the hierarchical structure of the folders and the subfolders. Folder name ICT consists of subfolder Technological Innovation. Further, Technological Innovation consists of a subfolder called e-learning. So friends, you are now well versed and have certainly created your own personalized library. Now, what to do with these documents? How to handle them? The next topic I'll be discussing is about handling Mendeley Library. The following functions can be applied on the documents that are stored in your Mendeley Library. First, open a file. Very crucial. You have stored something. Why not open that and read the content? So Mendeley provides you with this facility. You can either right-click and open the file or double-click and then open the file for reading. Second, open file externally. Document can also be opened from the source folder where it is actually stored in your computer. Third, read. The content of your document can be read by you. Next, highlight. The content of the document can be highlighted using different colors. For example, in a document, few lines are to be added in your introduction of your thesis. These can be highlighted with a yellow color. Another paragraph that you feel to add in the review of literature, you can change the highlight color and add these. Another option is annotate. User can make notes, that is, whatever comes in your thought process while reading a particular document can be noted down straight away in a PDF. As shown, displays a document that has been opened in Mendeley for reading. Viewers, if you see this figure, in the abstract, some content has been highlighted. How do you actually highlight a content? This can be done by selecting the content and then from the toolbar selecting the highlight button. Color can also be changed from this button. Another thing that is visible in this figure is a note that has been added. Note or the special content or the text that the user while reading this particular document want to elaborate. They are for future reference. If you see this figure, the date, time and the content that has been added in this note is visible. The next thing that you can do on a document is to delete a document if it is no longer required. Document can also be renamed. A document can also be marked. Document can be marked as read, unread, favorite, not favorite, needs review, reviewed. Documents that the user has marked as read are placed in built-in folder called recently read. Documents that have been marked as favorite are placed in built-in folder called favorite folder. According to Mendeley, those documents that need further review, that is, a review in the details, review in the metadata is required, are automatically placed in needs review folder. Search, it is always performed on the active folder. That is, if a folder is opened, then search is always performed on that folder and not on the other folders. Hence, it is a good practice to perform search operation usually in all documents. That is, whenever you are searching for some information from your Mendeley library, try to make your active folder all documents. Search can be performed to look for documents under the following subheadings: author name, author keywords, my tags, publications, title, year, notes that you have created for that document. Now, the documents that match the criteria, they will be displayed in the center pane of the Mendeley screen. Once a search has been performed, the search results must be cleared before performing another search. Else, the next search is performed by using these search results. So viewers, before ending with this module, let us just revise what we have done in this module. This module began with the introduction to Launch Mendeley. I'm sure by now all of you would have downloaded Mendeley onto your computer and created a Mendeley account. The next that we discussed here was what to add, where to add, and how to add. You all know that Mendeley supports 20 different types of documents that can be added. They can be added either from your computer or directly from the search engines or the academic databases. They can be added in a user-defined folder or in the built-in folder. Finally, after creating your own personalized library, I have discussed about the various functionalities or the various features which are available that you can explore on these documents that are stored in your Mendeley library. You can open a document to read, highlight, annotate the content. You can rename, delete a document. And most interestingly, you can double-click a document and fetch the details which are available on the right side of the document. That is the metadata. So viewers, I'm very sure about that you're having a good hands-on experience. See you till now. Hope to see you all in the next module, where I'll be discussing about how to do in-text citation and finally build your reference list, that is bibliography. Thank you.